Wave them at them bitches hating on you with their friends, girl, you got it. Hey y'all, so I don't even want to really get too deep into it, but I know it's been a while since I have made any type of content, and believe it or not, it's been a while since I even did my makeup, like a month and a half. But I'm back, so I'm gonna get into it. Your girl has relocated. I moved to a different state, y'all. I did something that I've always wanted to do, and I moved, and it's been about almost a month since I moved, and I must say that I am happy with my decision so far. I moved due to just a new job opportunity, a much better job opportunity, so I'm excited about that, to see where this takes me. It is in my same, without saying too much, it's in the same field that I've always worked in, just different responsibilities, let's say that. So I'm excited about that. What else have I been up to? I have braces. Well, on my personal page, I already posted this, but I have braces now, and I have to have them for, I think, 14 months. So I got them January 2nd to start the new year off, and they are supposed to come off in March, like March of next year, I think, maybe, depending on how it goes. So with my braces, at first I was like, why the heck did I do this? Like, they're so, this is what I thought at first. I was like, they're so tight, like they hurt so much, and I didn't know what I had got myself into. Let me scoot this back some. That's good. So I didn't know what I had got myself into. But as time went on, I started getting used to them, and they didn't hurt anymore. So I love them. It's just hard for me because I'm such an indecisive person. I just never know what color I want to get next. So this is my second band change. So the first band color I had was teal, and now I have black. So I have black bands right now, and I'm set to go in 2 weeks to get my next band color change, and I have no clue what color I want. None at all. So funny story, so when I got my band changed this time, I was like, okay, I know I want pink, because I've started loving pink. So I was like, I know I want pink. And I went in there and I sat in on people's chair, y'all, and got pink and thanked them for their time, walked out, sat in my car, and decided I no longer wanted pink. Because I didn't like it. It wasn't bright enough. It wasn't standing out. So I took myself back into them people establishment. Back in the people establishment, y'all. And told them it wasn't bright enough. And guess what? They were so nice and so accommodating that they told me it's okay. And they changed it for me. They went through and they chose different clips. I mean, different. They showed me the little, the band circle thing. They showed me different color choices, color waves or whatever. And I was able to choose the one that I really wanted. So, shout out to them. Even though I moved to a different state, I do still go to my same doctor or dentist, ortho, that is doing my braces, because I didn't want to change. And I think the scariest part for me is changing to a different dentist or orthodontist and having them take over my care and then do something totally different than what I had in mind. So yeah, I'm sticking with the same people that I go to now. So other than that, let me see what else I've been up to. I haven't been making, when I say no content, y'all, I mean no content. I haven't been promoting my business. I haven't even really been on social media like that, to be honest. I don't know what's been up with me. It's just not interesting anymore. My business stuff is interesting, but social media, I just been like, ugh, over it. So I think that's why I wasn't really motivated to do anything. But now I feel like it's time to get back into the routine of things. Yeah, so I'm gonna see how this round goes. But what else? Let me tell y'all how good God is. So even though I was not promoting my business, I was not doing anything on social media regarding SLC, Samorley Cosmetics, y'all, I was still getting orders. Like, still getting orders. I remember when I was home in Orlando and I was packing up my things and something told me to separate part of my inventory into the part that's going to be going with me and traveling with me, and breaking it up to the part that is going to be going like on the truck or in the storage or whatever. Y'all, that was the best decision that I made, because I was able to focus. Hold on. So I was able to focus on those orders that I received and still send them out without any delay. Granted, I was in a different state, but because on my Shopify, it's already labeled to have my P.O. box address that's from home, which is home is Orlando, then I didn't have any problem with that. And then I just ship them from here, from the store here. Let me see. All right, so right now I'm actually getting dressed to go get me a little drink. I was gonna go get my nails done. That's another thing. When you're moving to a different state, baby, finding like your services, somebody that can do what you like and do it the right way and also for a reasonable price, because I've never been into paying like high prices just because. Why would I do that? Yes, finding that is hard, y'all. I went and got my nails done once since I've been here, and let me show y'all. This is how my nails are. I've had them for about two and a half weeks. It's, look, y'all, not to flick y'all off, but look, I have never had this problem at home. My nails, they never broke. They never broke. They never chipped. They never did anything. And on these nails, y'all can't see it, but look how thick they are, y'all. You see that? I don't like that. I don't like it. But it's so hard finding like a good provider here. So I've been asking like the ladies at work, like, cause they're around my age group. So I've been like, where y'all go? Where y'all been going? So far I have two referrals. I was gonna go to one today to see how that would turn out, to give them a chance. But I just honestly don't feel like driving to that part of town. I don't. I'm sorry, y'all. You know, when you're doing your brows, you gotta concentrate. So that's that. I'm gonna put some primer. And the brushes I am using is from Samorley Cosmetics, but y'all knew that. I'm gonna try to do a whole get ready with me video. Let's see how that go. Prior to doing my face, I did moisturize my face first. I cleaned my face and I moisturized it. I used vitamin E oil. Then I used some of the, what is it called? Let me see. The snail mucin from CosRx. And then I used CosRx, their snail 92 all-in-one cream as a moisturizer. So, face is very plump and moist. All right, so now that I did that, I like to go in with my concealer. And I love E.L.F. Concealer. The Camo concealer. Love it. And I notice it's showing very yellowish on camera. And that's fine. I know what to do. Today I'm gonna do like real light. Real light beat. Just real light. I'm gonna let that dry a little bit, but I wanted to put some down here. So anyway, so back to my story. So what made me move out of state other than the job? So I just felt like stagnant. I felt very stagnant. And it's easy to feel that way when you are basically at home where you were born and raised and you're wanting to do more and you feel that, how to say it? You feel that you've hit your ceiling just a little bit. The reason I say that is because I was born in a little area outside of Orlando and been there all my life, except for when it was time for college. Went to Tallahassee to FAMU in Florida State, in Tallahassee. Stayed there for some years. After that, moved back home and been there ever since. And I feel as though, for one, when I was in college, I've always said that I never wanted to go back home. Never say never. So the reason I said I never want to go back home is because I felt that I've always wanted to move out of state. I wanted to move to Georgia. That's something I wanted when I was 20 something years old, early 20s. Had my child and decided like, okay, things didn't work out with me and his dad. I need to go back home where my support system is, get myself together, then I can move. Every time that I was wanting to move to Georgia, y'all, it was always something. I don't know. I can't remember what it was, but it was just always like something, like a barrier that made me either have to stay home or want to stay home. So then it got to the point where I'm like, okay, maybe I need to change my thought from Georgia and move to Texas. Mind y'all, at that time, I had never been to Texas. So what was the point of me moving there? And it was so far away from my family and my friends. And it would just be me and my son, which is perfectly fine. But that was never my desire until like just a random moment. So I'm like, okay, I don't want to just make no off the whim decision. So probably about 9 months ago, I was like, okay, it's time for me to move to Georgia. I started praying. I started feeling it. Like everything that like I was thinking about was like Georgia, 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 jobs, Georgia, Georgia, Georgia. So actually this was like almost 2 years ago because I had applied for a job in Georgia and I actually got the job and I psyched myself out of it to where I told them I would pass. Y'all, those people came back to me and offered me that same job 3 different times because I told them initially like, oh, the pay wasn't enough. They came back, they offered me a higher pay. I said, no, it's still not enough. They came back, they offered me another one, and they said that was the highest they can go. I told them, I was like, I appreciate it, I thank you, but no, I'm gonna explore other offers. Then people offered me it again. And at this point, I was so scared, like, okay, technically you would be like, okay, this is a sign, you need to go for it. Y'all, that mess scared me to the point where it's like, okay, now it's seeming real. What I want is right there. And I literally just told them no and went on about my business. And I had another job at home, luckily lined up. And this was right after the time that I had took that year off to focus on my business. So I'm like, okay, no, I can't afford to just be like out here just taking chances like that. Like, I just had a whole year off focusing on full-time entrepreneurship. And now that I want to go back into the career world, I'm like, is it the right move? I just kept second guessing myself, which in some ways you should, in some ways you shouldn't, especially if you believe in God and you say it's time to have faith. Certain things you should not just be second guessing yourself on. So anyway, I declined the job offers, and I just accepted the job locally at home, which turned out to be fine. It was great. I loved it. Loved the people that I was working with, but I just did not feel fulfilled. I felt like I was not focusing on my business. I felt that I was more so just like going to work and going home, or going to work, spending time with my child and my friends, and then just nothing. Like, I felt that that's all my routine consisted of. And I felt that I was losing sight of my true passion, which is makeup, my business. So I just had to start praying and meditating, not telling anyone what my plan and my thoughts were, just kind of, hold on y'all, just kind of focusing on myself, what I want and what I feel like I need and deserve. And y'all, late at night, around like midnight, I found myself like being on Indeed and just applying for jobs, like just in Georgia, just applying for jobs, just putting it out there. So what I noticed is I end up applying for that same job. That was like my number one choice. So I end up applying for that same job that I had initially declined a year and a half before. And I didn't hear nothing back from them. So I felt like, okay, maybe this is not meant to be. So I remember one night I just randomly applied for this job. And I'm like, okay, you know, what's the worst that they can say? I'm gonna just apply for it and see what happens. Y'all, I'm talking about like the next day. Like, I did that probably like 1 o'clock in the morning. So not that same day, but like the next business day, I literally heard back. And they were like asking me questions. Like, for one, they asked, did I realize that it's an out of state position and it's not telework or whatever, which I can't do my position from telework anyway. But I was like, yes, I do understand. And they asked me just questions like what made me my interests, what just things like work related things. I don't want to give too much details, but work related questions. Then they asked me to do a questionnaire. After I did the questionnaire, I submitted that. Then, like a day and a half later, they asked me for my references. I gathered my references. Shout out to my mentor. Shout out to my old boss. And shout out to a friend of mine. But I received those references. And I sent them off probably like the next business day. And then probably like 2 or 3 business days after that, I got invited for a job interview. Mind you, this was out of state and I was already currently working. So it's like, dang, okay. I was like, okay. So I remember they had offered me the interview on like on a Friday, and it was like Friday at like 3 something. And I didn't get back to them because I know I worked that Saturday, and then I know I was off Sunday and Monday, and I had to go to work on Tuesday. So I'm like, okay, they asked me my availability, but by the time I responded with my availability, they probably were off and could not respond to me in time. So I'm like, dang. Like, I talked to my big sister about it. She was like, this something you want? I was like, yeah. She's like, come up here and then confirm the details on Monday once you're already in town and just start looking for your place. I was like, but they didn't offer me the job. She's like, just start looking for your place. I was like, okay. So I drove there. I think it was like late Saturday night. I got there on Sunday, meaning to Georgia, to my sister's house. I got there on Sunday. And then, what happened? Got there on Sunday. Oh, I chilled with her. And then I was tired. So I remember I slept for a while. And then I end up going and looking for an apartment. And then Monday, I finally heard from them. And they were like, Monday I didn't hear anything. And it was already like 11 something in the morning. So I emailed them and I was like, hi, I just wanted to follow up. I am in town and I wanted to know when I would be able to secure the interview. I was looking more so for later today or early tomorrow. Let me know what works best for you all. That way I take more control of it, so I'm not gonna get an email from them saying, hey, can you meet Thursday? Because I'm not gonna be here Thursday. So I got an email and it was like, let's meet tomorrow, which was Tuesday. It's like, let's meet tomorrow. I was like, okay, thank you. We confirmed the time and the place. Y'all, I went to that interview. I was so calm that morning. And from my sister's house, it was about an hour and 30 minute drive. Hour and 20 minute drive, something like that. I was so calm on that drive. Like, I've never felt an interview go so well. In the interview, we talked about God. We talked about previous experiences, what led me to Georgia, and just like the timing of it all. Y'all, it just, they offered me a job on the spot, okay? And I'm getting teary-eyed thinking about it. They offered me the job on the spot. And of course, you say, you know, thank you so much. I would love to take some time and think about it because it's more things that go into it. So they was like, okay, no problem. Y'all, when I tell y'all, after we worked out all the technicalities, all the little things that you need to work out, when I tell you that was the best decision that I've made in a long time. And it's been about a month now since I've been with them, since I moved here and everything. Oh, mind you, I found my place the same weekend. Y'all, when my sister said, find a place, and I found it, everything just happened like seamlessly. Like, shout out to God. But when I tell y'all that was the best decision that I made in a long time, and I'm so proud of myself and happy for me and my son, y'all, that it all worked out. It all worked out. So far, I am loving it. I am loving my team. I am loving my place. I'm loving just every decision that I've made, and I feel like God allowed things to happen when it was supposed to, and I did what I was supposed to do. I was patient. Even though I really wanted to move years ago, I was patient. I waited and I listened to God and I was obedient, and I feel like it worked out better than I could have expected it to work out. So I'm thankful for that. Now, I ain't gonna lie, y'all, I miss my friends. Like, I definitely miss my friends. I miss my friends. But yeah, I think that's the only thing. Like, it's just moving to a new state, a new city, getting acclimated, and just learning more about your surroundings. Sorry, I was wetting my sponge. But yeah, just getting acclimated, learning more about your surroundings, and as a young woman, it's very important to not be so trusting of people, because people are crazy, y'all. I don't care how much we say, like, oh, you know, I want to do this, I want to do this. Like, you have to use your best judgment. So for me, that's like important, not being so trusting to these people, to strangers. And then I'm not really, I don't know if I can say this, but I'm not really interested in dating here in Georgia, for more reason than one. But I think for me, it's more so just finding my tribe, which I'm not rushing. I know that everything will happen when it's supposed to happen, and God will align me with the right people at the right time. So I'm not rushing that. But yeah, so that's pretty much what I've been up to. And business-wise, I'm going to try my best to be more consistent, because I find that when I am consistent with my business, of course, I get better results. But y'all, it's hard. Like, I don't see how people be on social media 24/7. And I know it's about posting your business and your content and stuff, but man, it can be kind of tiring. And I'm already a sleepy, busy person. So, like, I'll be having a million things to do, and I'll be like, let me take a nap. So, I'm working on that part. But, yeah. What else is new? Dating. So, I was dating, but I'm not anymore. Like, I don't know. I just find, like, I don't know what to say about that one. Like, crickets. Dating is tricky. I feel like when you're dating someone and you really like them, it's like, it's something that'll happen that'll be like, nope, don't like you no more. Like, not who I thought you were. And for me, I just don't have the patience for them type of situations. I just don't. So, the time that I was gonna put into dating, I feel like I just need to focus on me and my business and my baby. And I say my baby, but my son is 10. But, and the goals that I'm trying to accomplish, getting myself established in this new place. I just have so much better things, or things that take priority right now, than dating. At least that's what I say right now, right? But yeah. So this is my setting powder. I'm using the banana. This was on the TikTok shop, and it still is, but this one is actually sold out. I have a few left on my actual website, samoraleecosmetics.com. But I gotta restock, y'all. This one, I think banana sold out, and I think caramel, if I'm not mistaken. When I tell you this setting powder is like no other, okay. And I just like to put it in my areas that I get really oily, which is like my T-zone, my brows, my forehead, like all of them. It blends so well that it don't matter where you put it at, honestly. So that's what I did with that. So now what I like to do is go in with a little finishing powder just to knock off the excess. And then And I'll go back in and do that line down my nose. Y'all, I have to concentrate on this part because don't nobody want my nose that look like it's off center. Sometimes that's what mine can give. It be giving off center baddie. Then go in and do my little eyeliner. Move my long hair out of the way, y'all. All right, so I ain't gonna lie. This part, I might have to look in the mirror. Yeah, I might have to look in the mirror. In the eye soon. That's okay. My bad, y'all. The camera had went dead, so I had to replace the battery real quick. So basically, when the camera went dead, all I did was do my eyeliner. And now I'm gonna, now I'm gonna spray my face. And the fan. And it's important to fan your face until it dries. Because you don't want to mess nothing up. And of course, y'all know what lip I'm going to do. I'm not even going to hold y'all. I'm going to do a nude lip. And I think I might put something in the corner of my eyes. Or do white eyeliner underneath. I haven't decided yet. It's just about dry. Oh, hit myself. I think I am gonna do the white eyeliner underneath, y'all. Let me sharpen it a little bit. Alright. And even though it's like pointy like that, I like to make it like a little dull. Just so it don't fall off of my eye. So without pulling your eyelid down, just kinda Might have to pull it down. See, that's why I don't like to go too deep into my eye. Y'all see how that just broke off? It just did me a favor, though. Don't worry about that, how that came out, because I'm gonna go ahead and put some mascara on. And I am gonna put mascara on the bottom too, but I'm gonna use a different mascara. No lashes, these are my lashes. And no offense to the girlies that get their lashes done, but y'all, I used to get my lashes done and I'm so happy that I stopped, because for one, I don't be wanting that look every day, and then for two, I realized it used to like pull my lashes out so bad. I remember my lashes were so bald one time, y'all, after getting them done. I literally had to wear my glasses 24/7 just to keep from the air making my eyes water and like potentially getting bacterial in my eye. No, thank you. I feel like once you start getting your eyelashes done, you have to continue getting them done. And that's not something that I really wanted to do. Oh, this is the clear brow gel. So I will have to use this. I thought that was the black one, y'all. So I will have to use this one. So you gotta be very careful. What time is it? 3:08. Good time. Not feeling the under eyes, y'all, but it's all right. It's all good. It's all good. All right, so now get some tissue, wipe my lips, huh? Alright, so I'm just gonna use Brownie. Y'all know my go-to. If you don't know, now you know. And perfect. I really don't even have to go in again, but y'all know me. I can't leave well enough alone. Now I'm gonna go in with Nu.Dist. This is the lightest nude color. Don't need a lot for that, as you can see. Honestly, think I'm gonna put a little highlight on. I'm gonna use Ginger Babe. This is how it looks. It's like a bronzy highlight, loose highlight powder. You don't need a lot. Listen, tap the top, the lid, and blow it off. And then I'm just gonna just a little bit, just a little bit. So when the light hit it, See, just a little bit. And then I like to do the bridge of my nose, the tip of my nose, and the bridge. And after I do the bridge of my nose, I like to come back in with the brush that I use to contour it and just clean it up so that it's not everywhere. And that's that. Now, what I will do is also add some clear gloss. I like plain Jane. Don't need a lot for that either. And that's that. That's my makeup routine that I'm doing today. Wash my hands. Wash my hands so I could pick my hair out. And I said I was thinking about putting something in the corner of my eye, but I feel like that's a lot. So I'm just gonna leave it as is. And then we're gonna go get dressed. I feel like it look good. It's not too much. It's not too much. It's just enough. That's good.